So good morning students, and I welcome you all once again to the next session of design of RCC and steel structural elements. In the today's session we are discussing about the next part of design of gantry girder. Okay, so in the last session we had selected a section based on the thumb rule. As I told you in the last session, already I have discussed how to select a section. Okay, so with respect to that, here, so this is a cross section of our gantry girder. As I told you, we have to select I section with a channel section, a inverted channel section resting over top flange of the I section. Okay, so we have the I section here and a channel section resting over the top flange of the I section. Okay, so if you see here, so this part is called as web of I section. This is called as bottom flange, this is called as top flange, correct? And again for channel also, this is called as web and these two are the flanges. Okay, so before I have to explain that. Okay, so once again I'll explain. This part is called as web, this is bottom flange, top flange, and the channel is resting over the top flange of I section, and this is again the web of channel, and these two are the flange of the channel. Okay, so we have ISMC 300 and ISMB 600. Okay, we have selected these two for the design of gantry girder. So let us note down the properties of the selected section first. Okay, so we have to use steel table for that. You have to use the steel table to note down the properties of both the section, because those properties you have to utilize for further design purpose. Okay, so you have to utilize those properties. Okay, so for that you have to refer the steel table. So I'll show you how to refer and how to use those properties, how to note down those properties from steel table. Okay, so dear students, so these type of steel tables are available in the market. Okay, so you have to use this booklet. Okay, this is available like steel tables if you ask. Okay, they will provide you the steel tables. Okay, and this is the author by S. Ramamrutam. There are other authors also you can refer. Okay, so from this you have to refer the properties. Now if you open the steel table booklet, okay, you will get the properties for different types of sections. Now we have to refer for beams. Okay, it may be ISMB, ISWB, okay, I section, channel section, everything. Those are all called as rolled steel beams. Okay, so here you can see this is a I section. Okay, this is a I section, and here it is mentioned dimensions and properties, dimensions and properties. Now you have to refer for our section, that is ISMB 600. Okay, now if you open and refer here, so here we have table 1. Okay, dimensions and properties of rolled steel beams. So here we can see it's a beam, a rolled steel beam. So we have B, depth, then thickness of flange, thickness of web, TW, TF, everything. Okay, now if you come back here, here the first column is for designation, then next we have weight per meter. For particular section, what is the weight of the section, weight per meter. Then the cross sectional area, depth of section, width of flange, thickness of flange, then thickness of web. Okay, thickness of web. Then other properties are also provided here, so moment of inertia, radius of gyration, other properties, so on. Okay, now here you have to note down the properties. Okay, whatever the properties required for the further calculations and the dimensions you have to note down. Now if you look at here, it is mentioned ISJB. So it is Indian Standard Junior Beam. Okay. So likewise, there are n number of beams here. So ISJB, then ISLB we have. Then we have ISLB. Then we have ISMB here. If you go on searching, we have ISMB. Now you have to select for which section. You have to note down the properties for ISMB 600. Okay. You have to note down the properties for ISMB 600. Okay. So ISMB 600. So if you come back here, so we have ISMB 600 here. We have ISMB 600 and the properties are given here. So same properties you have to note down. You have to note down the properties, whatever the required properties. I'll tell you how to note down and which all properties required for the calculation. Okay. So the properties are required, like you have to, important is first one, area. What is the area? So area of the ISMB 600 is given here. 156.21 centimeter square. 156.21 centimeter square. Then the depth of the section is required. It is 600. Width of the flange is 210. Then the thickness of flange is 20.8, and the thickness of web is 12. Okay. So here these are the dimensions required to note down. Okay. So you have to note down the properties. These are the properties you have to note down. Properties and dimensions for ISMB 600 at 122.6 kg per meter. So ISMB 600, it is 122.6 kg per meter. Means it is a self weight of that section, particular section. Okay. 122.6 kg per meter. And next we have ISMC 300. It carries 35.8 kg per meter. Means the self weight of the section is 35.8 kg per meter for ISMC 300. Now we'll note down the properties from steel table. Okay, we'll note down the properties from steel table. So first property is area. So area is, it is given here, it is 15621. Okay, it is given here. Okay, it is given here. Okay, so here it is given 156.21 centimeter square. So we'll convert that in mm square and we'll note down. Then we have depth, we have width of flange, thickness of flange, okay. Then the thickness of web, okay, everything. Then we have the moment of inertia, about Ixx, Iyy. These are the properties we'll note down, okay. Now we'll note down the properties for ISMB 600. So in that we have the area. First is area is, it is 15621 mm square. 15621 mm square. Then next we have thickness of flange. So thickness of flange TF, it is given as TF. So it is 20.8 mm. So it is 20.8 mm. Okay. So it is 20.8 mm. Then we have width of flange, which is nothing but B. So it is 210 mm. So this is 210 mm. Okay. Then we have thickness of web, that is TW. Thickness of web, TW. It is 12 mm. So this is how much? 12 mm. Then next we have moment of inertia, that is Ixx and Iyy. So this is also mentioned. So it is 91. Ixx is 91. 813 into 10 is to 4 mm is to 4. So I request all of you to at least go once to the steel table and cross check these dimensions and properties. Okay. Then we have Iyy. So Iyy is 2651 into 10 is to 4 mm is to 4. Okay. These are the properties for Ixx and Iyy. Okay. Then the depth of section. The depth of section is 600 mm. Okay. Depth of section is 600 mm. So Cyy for ISMB it is not required. We required for ISMC 300. Okay. So these are the properties you have to note down properly. Don't do any mistakes while noting down these properties. If you do any mistakes, there will be mistake in the calculation for the further part. Okay. Then next we have to go for ISMC 300. Okay. Okay, so now for ISMC 300. So the area is 45 4, 6, 4. Okay, so the area is 4, 5, 6, 4 mm square. Okay, then the thickness of flange, the thickness of flange is 13.6. It is 13.6. Then the width of flange is 90 mm. So that is 90 mm. Okay. Then we have thickness of web. The thickness of web is given here. It is 7.6. So here it is 7.6 mm. Okay. Then the moment of inertia. Okay. Then here the moment of inertia IXX is 6362. So IXX is 6362.6 into 10 raised to 4 mm raised to 4. 6362.6 into 10 raised to 4 mm raised to 4. Then we have IYY. So IYY is 310.8 into 10 raised to 4 mm raised to 4. So these are the properties, the moment of inertia for channel section. Then we have the depth of section is 300 mm. Okay, it is 300 because see, whenever you select section ISMB 600, it is nothing but with respect to the depth of section. So 600 means the depth will be 600. Now here ISMC 300 means the depth of the section should be 300. Then the CYY is also available here. So it is given as 23.6. So here it is 23.6 mm. Okay, 23.6 mm. So these are the properties you have to note down properly. Okay. So here the same dimensions I have represented over the diagram. So the depth of the section is 600 for I section. For channel section it is 300. The thickness of web, thickness of flange. Okay. Now by using these properties, okay, we have to find out the moment of inertia of gantry girder. Okay. Now to go for next, that is moment of inertia of gantry girder. Okay. The moment of inertia of gantry girder. Okay. So for that, the section is here, it is not symmetrical about the horizontal axis. The I section with channel section, it is only symmetrical about what is vertical axis. Okay. So first of all, for that, you have to find out the location of centroid. Okay. The location of centroid or the neutral axis. Okay. So here, therefore, the distance of neutral axis of built up section, the distance of neutral axis of built up section from the extreme fiber of compression flange the distance of neutral axis of built up section from the extreme fiber of compression flange or also it is called as bottom flange, compression flange or bottom flange. Okay. So for that it is nothing but y bar b. Okay. So it is summation of ay divided by summation of area. Understood? That is summation of a into y divided by summation of area. Okay. So we will consider for I section and as well as channel section. Okay. So that is here the area is 15621. So here it will be a1 y1 plus a2 y2. So 1 for I section, 2 for channel section, okay, A1 Y1, A2 Y2, and it is A1 plus A2, correct? So A1 15621 into Y1 is 300 plus A2 is 4564 into here it is 600 plus 7.6 minus 23.6 divided by 15621 plus 4564. So we get this as that is Y bar B, that is 364.21 mm. Understood? That is from bottom flange. So I'll explain here. Okay, I'll explain here. Okay. Now for ISMB, the area is 15621 into, see, total depth of the section is how much? 600. And the center of the section will be 600 by 2. So that is 300, correct? So that's why I have taken here. Into 300. 15621 into 600 by 2. Plus for channel. For channel area is 4564. Okay. So for channel, the area is 4564. Into 600. So this is very, very important here. Into 600. So 600 is totally 600. Plus 7.6. So this is 7.6 here. So the thickness of web of channel section. So this is 7.6. Understood? 600 plus 7.6. So that we got total height. Minus 23.6 is nothing but. So here minus 23.6 is nothing but. Here what you can see? This height. This end means the centroid of channel. The centroid of channel is at a distance of 23.6 from the here, and that is nothing but we are noted down as CYY. CYY. So that is 23.6. Understood? 600. Clear? 600 plus 7.6 minus 23.6. 600 plus 7.6 minus 23.6. divided by total area. So we get Y bar. Okay. Y bar from bottom. So we got Y bar from bottom is 364.21 mm. Okay. So if you want from top or Y bar T, if you want Y bar T. So total height, that is 600 plus 7.6. That is a total height. Minus bottom, so we get this as 364.21. Okay, so Y bar T, we get it as 243.39 mm. So we got Y bar bottom and Y bar top. So we'll locate that. We'll locate that now. Okay, so I'll just locate the neutral axis now with respect to Y bar bottom or top. Okay, so this is a neutral axis we have. This is the neutral axis, and these are the properties we have calculated. So we have got the location of neutral axis from the bottom flange. So that is Y bar B. Y bar B, we got it as Y bar B. It is 364.21. It is what? 364.21 mm. Understood? So the location of neutral axis or the centroid, the location of neutral axis from the bottom flange, it is 364.21 mm. So vertical we don't have any problem because it is symmetrical about vertical axis, so it will be in the center, but we have to find out the horizontal axis. Okay, so we have found out, so it is 364.21 mm. So regarding today's session, if you have any queries, okay, after watching through this video, if you get any queries, you can add those queries in comment box. Okay, thank you very much.